You volunteer. Danny, you show.
Yeah. do 180.
3D. Sang it today. It's worth it all. I didn't know my voice. Never did have no voice. Y'all pray for us. Help me sing this, would you? When we are tried and things go wrong, we sometimes sing, trust in Him and wear a smile. It's worth it all to be His child. Ain't that the truth? It's worth it all to be His child, to serve Him through. career. Although we bear reproach and shame, it's worth it all for His dear name. The tides of life may rather fall, but the love of God is worth it all. It's worth it all to be His child, to serve Him through the last long mile. It's worth it all to feel His power and know He gives every hour. When here on earth is run, we see the rays of the setting sun. When He shall hear that final call, we'll tell the world,
so will
it's worth it all.
Praise God.
It's worth it all to be His child,
say amen to that.
Amen.
It's worth it all. It's worth it all. Sing, Bob.
Praise the Lord.
The redeemed are coming.
Thank you, Jesus. Careful, sing, Lord. Bless you, Jesus.
I've been standing there at the gate looking down together there, broken garments white as snow, walking streets of pure gold. All the saved are coming home evermore. Sweet it is to hear Mama singing.
bless his name. I'd like to put my feet in this water tonight.
What is it? How's it going?
There came a sound from heaven, like the mighty rushing wind. It filled their hearts with the prophet gave his promise, the Spirit will descend, and from your intervening, a river will flow in. There is a river from deep within. There is a fountain that frees the soul from sin. Come to this water, there is a path supply. Drawing from a well, her life was ruined and wasted, her soul was bound for hell. Then she met the Master, who told of her took Isaac to the mountain so high, and Isaac said, Father, we have no sacrifice, but Abraham obeyed God, and God honored him.
Amen.
And knew to his promise, God provided a lamb.
Yes.
And he's the same one that provided for Isaac that day. He's the same God that came down to a manger of hay. He's the same God. that John preached about
400 years in darkness, God spoke not a word.
Thank you,
then
Jesus.
Out of the wilderness, brothers, John's voice was heard. He said that one is to come and bring the good news. And I am not worthy to unloosen his shoes. And he's the same God that provided for Isaac that day. He's the same God that came down to a manger of hay. He's the same God today. Oh, it makes me wanna shout. He's the very same God that John preached about. And he's done everything he said he would do. But come back and get me, and he'll do that too.
Yes. Testify, Caleb, sang another one, buddy.
I'm thankful for saving me and for all that he's done for me, for always keeping me safe and for always going to keep me safe.
Yes. God bless the Lord. Amen. Well, I'm having a good time tonight. How about y'all? Praise the Lord. Amen. Bless his name. Good singing, folks. Thank God.
I am redeemed. Last time.
Brother Corey, testify tonight. Testify, Brother Corey.
I'm glad to be here. I'm glad I can testify tonight.
Yeah, praise the Lord.
What God's done. He's been awful good to me.
Yeah.
He's watched out over me.
Yeah.
Provided for me, took care of me.
Amen.
He's given me a home to go to when this life on earth is over there. That's the best thing he can do for me.
That's right.
And I'm glad that I know him. I'm glad he knows me.
Amen. Amen, brother. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise his name. Ever-fold.
Praise the Lord for watching over us and traveling and everything.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Bless you, Jesus.
I've been told there's a place called heaven, and I've been told the streets there are pure gold. And I know a man that saw that new Jerusalem, but still the half has not been seen.
She don't know it.
Feel liberty tonight to obey God. tonight is to turn to Isaiah chapter 1 tonight. Try to preach a few minutes, a little bit help us. Ain't this a good night to be in church?
Amen. It's a good night to be in the house of the Lord. And I've traveled many miles, and I don't say this in an arrogant way because I know God hates bragging. I've traveled many miles to win souls for the Lord. But the desires of my heart is in this church tonight. Amen. And that's my children. I want my children to make heaven their eternal home. Ain't that right? I want my family to make it to heaven. And I love all of you, and all of you are close to me. And I want your family to make it. I want your children. But I won't be satisfied until I, amen, hear a testimony and know beyond a shadow of a doubt that my family's bearing fruit for God. And I want to see everybody's family to do that. I want to see everybody's children, amen, come to the knowledge of Jesus Christ. And that's something you can't make happen. That's something that God's got to do all by himself. He's got to do every bit of it. But I want all of you tonight, this is a good service tonight. Amen. I like to see the house full. A lot of our folks is gone and different things, reasons and different things like that. But I can worship the Lord if it's 10 or 100. Amen. I mean this, I appreciate God's blessings upon us today. God's been good to us. And I pray tonight, if you're here and you're not a Christian and you don't know the Lord and you're not living where you need to be with God, that you'd take notice of things in this world. This world is getting pretty bad. It's getting bad. And we see, I was telling somebody the other day about all the things that Biden's are doing and everything that as far as the taxes and the money and all like that. I ain't got enough sense to understand all that, but I do know one thing. When I see this homosexual stuff rising up the way that it is, that right there, that lets me know, according to this book right here, God will not put up with that. He's not going to put up with that. He's not going to do it. So, when I read the scriptures tonight, when we look down there, and every one of us are so quick to say, you know, Biden's letting the borders open and all these people come in, that might not be all of Biden's doings. That may be some of God's doings, because when God's people does what America has been doing, I'm going to read to you tonight what happened to Israel. Amen. When Israel didn't do what God wanted them to do, he said the strangers would come in and possess your land. He said the strangers would come in and live in your houses. So it's a fearful thing tonight not to be ready to meet God. I'm not going to preach long. Amen. But if you're here tonight and you're not a Christian and you don't have the Spirit of God, I just want to ask you a question. Why won't you come to God? Amen. Why won't you surrender your life to Jesus? Give your life to the Lord. It's the best way of living. Amen. It's the best way of living. I'm a happy person. Are you a happy person? Are you a Christian? Are you a happy person tonight? I mean, if you're saved tonight, I mean, I think we ought to be happy people. Amen. It ain't because of the material things that God has given us. There's a joy down deep inside. In Isaiah chapter 1, and we'll read just a few verses here till the Lord says that's enough. Amen. In Isaiah chapter 1, verse number 3, Isaiah ain't a happy preacher. And he's delivering the message from God to the people of Israel. And he starts out in verse number 3, and he said, "The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib, but Israel does not know. My people doth not consider. Ah, sinful nation, a people laden with iniquity, a seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger. They're gone away backwards now." They may tell you you can't backslide, but they're lying to you. Amen. Israel backslid. "Why should ye be stricken anymore? You will revolt more and more. The whole head is sick." And that's when you're in trouble. when the whole head is sick, the whole head is sick, and the whole heart faint. From the sole of the foot, even to the head, there's no soundness in it, but wounds and bruises, putrefying sores. They've been closed, neither they have not been closed, neither bound up, neither mollified with ointment. Your country's desolate. Your cities are burned with fire. Your land, strangers devour it in your presence. It's desolate, as overthrown by strangers. The daughter of Zion is left as a cottage in a vineyard, as a lodge in a garden of cucumbers, as a besieged city. Except the Lord of hosts had left unto you a very small remnant, we should have been as Sodom, and we should have been made like unto Gomorrah. Hear the word of the Lord, ye rulers of Sodom. Give ear unto the law of our God, ye people of Gomorrah. What purpose, listen to this, what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifices unto me? Saith the Lord, I'm full of burnt offerings, of rams, fat of beasts. I delight not in the blood, bullocks of lambs and goats. Now this right here will make everybody, if you ain't been listening to the scripture, listen to this. He said, when you come to appear before me, who hath required this at your hand to tread my courts? Bring no vain oblations. Incense is an abomination unto me. The new moons and Sabbaths, the calling of assemblies, I cannot away with it. It's iniquity. Even the solemn meeting, your new moons and your appointed feast, and your my soul hateth, they're trouble unto me. I weary to bear them. When you spread forth your hands, I will hide mine eyes from you. When you make your prayers, I will not hear. Your hands are full of blood. That's all that we'll read tonight. Well, that's bad, ain't it? Amen. That's a bad way for God's people to get in tonight. Amen. And what I'm reading about in whole tonight is Israel in Isaiah's day, how that they had, amen, turned away from the God of their fathers. And Jeremiah wrote about it and said that they'd committed two evils. They'd forsaken the fountain of living waters. Amen. They'd forsaken God. And then in the second part, he said that how they'd hewn them out cisterns that wouldn't hold no water. Amen. And one prophet said that when they go to the house of God, he said, consider your ways. He said, when you come to the house of God, he said, you've got bags in them, and you get what you can gather from the people of God and the preacher and the church. But he said, you forgot one thing. Amen. There's holes in your bags. So when you're leaving out, amen, the thing that you got, that you knew, that you learned down at the house of God, you forgot to do that. Now I know on this Sunday night that I've got some good faithful people here that love God, and amen, people tonight that care about God. But I want to talk just a minute about the church, brother, and the shape that the church has got itself into. Amen. And the results of a friend of iniquity. Now iniquity is what separates a brother, a man from God. It's the message that the world and the fleshly church and the worldly church, a brother, does not want to hear. Amen. We want our ears tickled and told everybody's going to heaven, everybody's going to see the streets of gold. But friend, I read different. I am the word of God. The Bible said straight is the gate and narrow is the way. Amen. There's going to be just a few that finds what eternal life, a friend, is all about. But I don't know about you, but I've got a desire in my heart to make heaven my eternal home. Amen. I want to hear the Lord say, well done, thy good and thy faithful servant. He's looking at the church as we've been preaching about the body of Jesus Christ in Sunday school. Amen. When that body is fully functioning, amen, there'll be healings, there'll be words of knowledge, there'll be words of wisdom, there'll be miracles, there'll be great and mighty deeds. And when the body of Christ is exercising in the shadow of God's word, and they love God with all of their heart. But Isaiah looked at a people, amen, that had forsaken God. He said, the ox, they know who their owner is. He said, the ass,
where the stall is. He said, but my people, and you see everybody that goes to church, amen, and says the name of Christ, that does not mean that they're a Christian. But I can tell all of you tonight, amen, how you can tell if you're a Christian tonight, you're fighting the world of sin. If you're fighting against it tonight, that's a good sign that you're saved tonight, because the world, they're not fighting it at all. They've completely surrendered to it. If the devil tells them to sin, that's exactly what they'll do. If the devil tells them to do this, that's exactly what they'll do. And the church of the living God, that used to be the apple of God's eye, give me a little volume, boys, amen, the apple of God's eye, now has got itself in a place that Isaiah has come and said, you come to church and you bring me your oblations and you bring me your sacrifice. He said, but when you hold your hands up, he said, I cannot take my head and even look down at you. When you open your mouth to praise me, my ears, I cannot hear you. This new church age and this new church world and this new church worship and this new church religion, amen, it's not of God. The Bible said there'd be two women in the field. Brother, there's two churches tonight. Amen. There's the church of the living God, of the Jesus Christ, of the Son of God, of that when he saves a man, he cleans a man up. Brother, he brings you out of sin. And I'm not telling you tonight that you won't see it. When Solomon was praying before the temple dedication, he said, God, if there be any man sin. And then Brother Junior, he stopped in his prayer and he said, there's no man upon the earth that does not sin. We all make mistakes and we all fight the battle. But church, I don't want you to leave here thinking tonight that you can sin and get by with it. It cost God his only begotten son. Amen. His son had to bleed and to die and to be buried and resurrected the third day. It wasn't no easy task being the Son of God. It's the same message of that John the Baptist preached, who hath warned you of the flee the wrath to come, of the body got in such a mess, of that the writer of Isaiah said, this body, the head, is a mess. Of the body has got wounds and petrifying sores. It ought to be a functioning in the ways of God, but it's not. Amen. It's got iniquity. And God said, I cannot, I will not, I shall not hear your prayers. I will not hear your oblations, brother, unto me. Don't be deceived tonight. Amen. You can deceive yourself and thinking that you're okay, and you can still have sin if you've got sin. And preacher, what is sin? They're listed in the book of Galatians, of the works of the flesh. Amen. Fornication, adultery. Amen. The letter adultery. Amen. Lasciviousness, and on and on. And the apostle Paul said, he that committeth these things shall not inherit of the kingdom of heaven. Amen. There's two women in the field. Amen. One of them's going to be taken, and the other's going to be left. There's another church. That's what made your daughter get so mad at me. She is telling me all about the things she could do. Amen. And drink alcohol and smoke marijuana and live and cuss and do all of these things. And finally, after I wasn't going to argue with her, after so long, I said, okay. I said, I'm sure it's okay. Amen. She said, what do you mean? I knew that there was a difference in my spirit. I just give in, surrender to you. I said, but there's another Jesus. Amen. And this Jesus, brother, is a false Jesus. Amen. He's the Jesus that they're taking these rock and roll tunes Are you hearing me tonight? Amen. Do you think God gets anything out of these hundreds of thousands of teenagers? Amen. And this worldly crew, brother, getting up. Amen. Singing these ungodliness. Amen. Living ungodly lives. A godly beat of a music and putting a few words of Christ in it. A rapping Christian. They ain't no such thing as a rapping song for God. They are you. Come on. If y'all don't amen me, I'm going to burn this place down. Amen. I'm telling you the truth. Hallelujah to God. They ain't no such thing. Oh, preacher. Amen. It's again the young people. I tell you what it's doing. It's making the head sick. And it's making the wounds get worse. Hallelujah to God. We need that old time singing. That old time preaching. Hallelujah. The old time worship of God. And keep sin out of our life. And then God said, I'll hear from heaven. He said, prove me. He said, the thing that can't worm eat up of the thing, amen, that my armies and the locust got. He said, I can restore it and bring it back. Amen. It makes me sick. And I believe it makes God sick. I just see what gathers in his house on Sunday, holding up their hands to worship God. Amen. When the worship and the praise leader, amen, them hands have turned up alcohol on Saturday night. Have them hands that scratch lottery tickets on Saturday night. Have them eyes that was full of pornography on Saturday night. Help me while I preach. Amen. They come into the house of God on Sunday. Amen. And the choir leader says sing. And the worship leader is like an orchestrator of telling them when to lift up hands. And them hands goes up. And then God takes his hands and covers his face. He said, you've turned my house. He said, your land is left unto you desolate. We're in a day that our churches are ordaining homosexuality. They're letting the hells and the things of this world into the house of God. Had to get the numbers bigger on the back of the board. Had to pay. But I'm going to tell you tonight, amen, if the gospel of Jesus Christ, amen, don't get them here at Antioch. Oh, tonight we're not after them with a hot dog. We're not after them with a ball game. We're trying to win them and to get them out of sin, and that the works of the flesh might be crucified, that there may be a Pentecost happen in their lives. Woo! I'm feeling like preaching. Amen. You know about it? I know the generation that I'm preaching to tonight. Amen. Most of you tonight, you ain't got no problem with this, with what I'm preaching, because you know that the thing that the church is trying to put on us now, it don't feel right. It don't seem right. Amen. Contemporary worship. Amen. Traditional worship. All these things, amen, trying to attire, to lure the people in, to try to get them in by the hundreds. And let me tell you something. Them jokers ain't been called of God. Amen. I don't care what and how much Bible they know. You can't go to school to be a preacher. I met a man, a young boy one day, Brother Andy. He's a teenager. He said, Preacher Nunley, he said, I want to be three things. I want three things when I grow up. I said, what's that? He said, I want to be a police officer. He said, I want to be a firefighter. Or I want to be a preacher. Amen. I looked at him and I said, you can be a police officer and you can be a firefighter, but you cannot be a preacher. He looked at me and said, why can't I be a preacher? I said, if God's calling is not upon you, you can't take it upon yourself. You read the book of Hebrews about the priesthood of God, and God said, no man taketh this honor upon himself. But when a man's called, he's called of God. If you're a God-called man, brother, you're sick in your stomach of the hell that's going on in our land, and the churches are getting dead. He said, can a maid forget her wedding garments? He said, days without number, my people has forgot the ways of heaven. This old time way is left at now. My kind of preaching that all of you are used to. Young kids now sit back and laugh and look and giggle and make fun. Amen. They laugh at it. But I'm going to tell you one thing. There's a God in heaven that's getting fed up with it. There's a God in heaven, and we wonder why our economy and our nation's in the mess it's in. I'll tell you the reason why. We've corrupted the things of heaven. We forgot our God. Our church is winning its own name. We've hewed out our own cisterns, and the petrifying sores are getting greater and greater all the time. Woo! You say, preacher, what is it? It's S-I-N. That's all it is. It's S-I-N. That's all it is. It's sin. And when you get sin in your life, you can't go on with God. Oh no, it'll grieve you to death. I know all about it. Sin's tried to get me in many of a day. It has. It'll grieve God. The Bible said, grieve not the Spirit. And when you get saved, the Spirit of God's inside you. Amen. And then when you get saved, when the devil tries to tempt you and lure you away, there's a grieving there. Am I not right? Come on now. Am I telling it the truth? Amen. You know that you can't do that and still have the blessing of God. That's why when you come to church, you better get every piece of jelly, every bit of ice cream, everything that you can get, because that's what keeps me going. Amen. I couldn't make it in a dead church. I couldn't just go and plop down. Amen. And not worship God and get in the Holy Ghost. I got to have this to make me live right. Are y'all hearing me tonight? I got to have this prayer. Hallelujah to God. To make me get a hold of the Lord and walk up right before Him. I don't want to live an ungodly life and die and go to hell. All right, I'm about done. I preach on a little more. Let me ask you this. How many congregations, how many pulpits in our land today? And I know there's some. I'm not saying that Antioch's